Eagle Stirreth a nest. The eagle here is used to symbolize God's care and God's concern for his people.
Amen.
Many things have been used as symbolic expressions to give us a picture of God or some characteristic or one of his attributes. The ocean with her turbulent majesty, the mountains, the land, many things have been employed as pictures of either God's strength, of God's power,
yes,
of God's love,
yes,
of God's mercy.
Yes.
And the psalmist has said that the heavens declare the glory of God.
Amen.
And the firmament show forth his handiwork.
Amen.
So the eagle here is used as a symbol of God. Now, in picturing God as an eagle stirring her nest, I believe history has been one big nest that God has been eternally stirred,
yes,
to make man better, and to help us achieve world brotherhood. Some of the things that have gone on in your own experiences have merely been God stirring the nest of your circumstances. Now, the Civil War, for example, and the struggle in connection with it was merely the promptings of providence to lash man to a point of being brotherly to all men. In fact, all of the wars that we have gone through, we've come out with new outlooks and new views and better people. So that throughout history, God has been stirring the various nest of circumstances surrounding us so that he could discipline us, help us to know ourselves, and help us to love one another, and to help us hasten on the realization of the kingdom of God. The eagle symbolizes God because there is something about an eagle that is a fit symbol of things about God. In the first place, the eagle is the king of fowls.
Yeah.
And if he is a regal or kingly bird, in that majesty, he represents the kingship of God, or symbolizes the kingship of God. Listen, if you please. For God is not merely a king.
No.
He is the king. Somebody has said that he is the king of kings. For you see, these little kings that we know, they've got to have a king over them. They've got to account to somebody for the deeds done in their body. But God is the king. And if the eagle is a kingly bird, in that way he symbolizes the regalness and kingliness of our God. In the second place, the eagle is strong. Somebody has said that there, as the eagle goes winging his way through the air, he can look down on a young lad grazing by a mountainside and can fly down and just with the strength of his claw pick up this young lad and fly away to yonder cliff and devour because he is strong.
Amen.
If the eagle is strong, then in that he is a symbol of God.
Yes, sir.
For our God is strong.
Yes, sir.
Our God is strong. Somebody has called him a fortress. So that when the enemy is pursuing me, I can run behind him. Somebody has called him a citadel of protection and redemption. Somebody else has said that he's so strong until they call him a leaning pole. That thousands can lean on him. And he'll never get away. I don't believe you praying with me. People have been leaning ever since time immemorial. Abraham leaned on him. Isaac and Jacob leaned on him. Moses and the prophets leaned on him. All the Christians leaned on him. People are leaning on him all over the world today. He's never given away. He's strong. That's strong. Isn't it so? In the second place, he's swift. The eagle is swift. And it is said that he can fly with such terrific speed that his wings can be heard roaring in the air. He's swift. And if he's swift in that way, he's a symbol of our God. For our God is swift. I said he's swift. Sometimes, he'll answer you. Why are you calling him? He's swift. Daniel was thrown in a lion's den. And Daniel rung him on the way to the lion's den. And having rung him, God had dispatched an angel from heaven. And by the time that Daniel got to the lion's den, the angels had changed the nature of lions and made them lay down and act like lions. He's swift. Swift. One night, Peter was put in jail, and the church went down on its knees to pray for it. And while the church was praying, Peter knocked on the door. God was so swift in answering prayer. So that if the eagle is a swift bird, in that way he represents or symbolizes the fact that God is swift. He's swift. If you get in honest tonight and tell him about your troubles, he's swift to hear you. All you do is need a little faith and ask him in grace. Another thing about the eagle is that he has extraordinary sight. Extraordinary sight. So that it is said that he can rise to a lofty height in the air and look in the distance and see a storm hours away. As extraordinary sight. And sometimes he can stand and gaze right in the sun. Because he has extraordinary sight. I want to tell you, my God has extraordinary sight. He can see every ditch that you've dug for me. And guide me around. God has extraordinary sight. He can look behind that smile on your face. And see that frown in your heart. Extraordinary sight. Then it is said that an eagle builds a nest unusual. It is said that the eagle selects rough material basically for the construction of his nest. And then as the nest graduates toward a close or a finish, the material becomes finer and softer, like down at the end. And then he go about to set up residence in that nest. And when the little eaglets are born, she go out and bring in food to feed them.
But when they get to the point where they're old enough to be out on their own, why, the eagle will begin to pull out some of that dung.
Yes.
And let some of those thorns come through.
Yes.
So that the nest won't be, you know, so comfortable.
Yes.
So when they get to lounging around,
yes,
and rolling around, the thorns prick them here and there.
Yes.
Pray with me if you please.
Yes.
I believe that God has to do that for us sometimes.
Yes.
Things are going so well, and we are so satisfied, but we just lounge around and forget the prayer. You walk around all day and enjoy God's life, God's health, and God's strength. And go climbing the bed without saying, thank you, Lord, for another day journey. We'll do that. God has to pull out a little of the plush around us.
Yes.
A little of the comfort around us.
Yes.
And let a few thorns of trial,
yes,
and tribulation stick through the nets,
yes,
to make us pray sometimes.
Yes.
Isn't it so?
Yes.
For most of us forget God,
yes, right,
when things are going well with us.
Yes.
Most of us forget it.
Yes.
It is said that there was a man who had a poultry farm.
Yes. Yes.
And that he raised chickens for the market.
Yes.
And one day in one of his broods, he discovered a strange looking bird.
Yes.
That was very much unlike the other chickens on the yard.
Yes.
And the man didn't pay too much attention, but he noticed as time went on that this strange looking bird,
yes,
was unusual.
Yes.
He outgrew the other little chicken. His habits were stranger and different.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, Lord. But he let him groan and let him,
yes,
mingle with the other chicken.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. And then one day a man who knew eagles, when he saw it, came along and saw that little eagle walking,
yes,
in the yard. And he said to his friend, do you know that you have an eagle here? The man said, well, I didn't really know it.
Come on.
But I knew he was different from the other chicken. And I knew that his ways were different.
Yeah.
And I knew that his habits were different.
Yeah.
And he didn't act like the other chicken.
Yeah.
But I didn't know that he was an eagle. But the man said, yeah, you have an eagle here on your yard.
Yes. Oh,
and what,
yes,
you ought to do is build a cage.
Yes.
But after a while, when he's a little older, he's going to get tired of the ground.
Yes,
yes, he will.
Yes.
He's going to rise up on the pinion of his wings.
Yes.
Yes. And as he grows, why, you can change the cage and make it a little larger as he grows older and grows larger. The man went out and built a cage. And every day he'd go in and feed the eagle. But he grew a little older and a little older. Yes, he did. His wings began to scrape on the sides,
yes,
of the cage.
Yes.
And he had to build another cage.
Yes.
And open the door of the old cage and let him into a larger cage.
Yes,
yes, he did. Oh, Lord. And after a while, he had to build that one cage. And then he had to build another cage.
Yes.
So one day, when the eagle had gotten grown, Lord God, his wings were 12 feet from tip to tip. Oh, Lord, he began to get restless in the cage. Yes, he did. He began to walk around and be uneasy. Why, he heard noises in the air. A flock of eagles flew over, and he heard word. There goes it. And though he'd never been around Eagle, there was something about that voice that he heard that moved down in him and made him dissatisfied. Oh, Lord. And the man watched him as he walked around uneasy. Oh, Lord. He said, Lord, my heart goes out to him. I believe I'll go and open the door and set the eagle free. Oh, Lord. He went there and opened the door. Yes. The eagle walks out. Spotted his wings. Yeah. Up and down. Yes. The eagle walks around. A little longer. And he flew up a little higher. And went to the barnyard. Yes. He sat there for a while. He flew up a little higher. Tree. Yes. And then he went up a little higher and flew beyond the mountain. Yes. 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 One of these days, my soul is an eagle in a cave that the Lord had made for me. Yes, it is. And one of these days, the man who made the cage will open the door and lock my soul. Yeah. You ought to be able to see me take the wings of my soul. Here I ended up with Gordon and Cuba and